Get all these bananas and empty pins and empty pin bananas and all that stuff.
We're talking, that is one awesome clutch. Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog. I am in the incubator, and I'm not going to be cutting eggs today, but I'm going to be checking a few clutches that are about to hatch before I head over to the building. Take a look at these. This is the first clutch here. Oh my gosh, it's so exciting. Of course, this is an albino bred to an Enchi heifer albino. This would happen to be just a really beautiful albino ball python. And then this one here, that's the crown jewel right there. That is an Enchi albino. Oh my god. I love the way Enchi mixes with almost everything, and then you put it in with an albino. Oh my god, that is a gorgeous snake. And I love starting the day checking on baby snakes. This is actually a pastel ivory bred to an ivory. So everything in this clutch, because the ivory is a super yellow belly, is going to be yellow belly. This one here is a really beautiful pastel yellow belly. And then here's another really pretty pastel yellow belly. And then this, of course, is the super version here, which is the ivory ball python. Now this one isn't a pastel ivory, it's just an ivory. A little bit of a bummer that we didn't get more ivories out of this clutch, but hey, I'm happy that we get beautiful babies. And those are some awesome animals. Ooh, Toki, look at this clutch. Oh man, that's some beautiful animals. This was actually an Enchi pin banana bred to a yellow belly, so there's gonna be some crazy stuff. This happens to be just an Enchi pin banana here. Looks like this one is just a pin banana. It's a little bit hard to see some of these, to be totally honest with you. This one here is definitely an Enchi pin banana. It appears to be a yellow belly because the yellow belly will cause the patterning and the color to change just a little bit. But there's a bunch of really, oh my god, look at this animal right here. Oh my god, this of course is an Enchi pin yellow belly. And this is a great example of the difference between an Enchi pin and an Enchi pin yellow belly. The Enchi pin yellow belly, of course, is that really bright, beautiful, blushed out animal. And then this is just an Enchi pin here. Still an absolutely gorgeous snake, but look at all these bananas and Enchi pins and Enchi pin bananas and all that stuff. And this is a little Enchi here. Hoo doggy, that is one awesome clutch. And here's another awesome clutch. Oh my god, this is actually a super pastel fire banana bred to a spinner, and there are some stunners in here. This is just a spinner blast, of course, which is the pastel pinstripe and a spider gene right here. It might possibly have some fire in it too. It's hard to tell. Just some pinstripes here. This, of course, looks like a banana spider right here. Possibly a fire, I'll be able to tell. This animal right here. Ooh, doggy, that one is beautiful. That is actually a fire banana spinner. Oh my gosh, that thing is incredible. Oh, and look at this, guys. Oh, here's another one. This is another Enchi banana spinner right here. Look at that. Oh my gosh. So these two are all the genes mixed together. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. And just to give you an example, this would be a banana spinner without the fire. You can see how faded these guys are compared to that. That's that fire gene going on. Oh my gosh, look at how beautiful this one is right here. That would actually be a bumblebee fire banana. Oh my gosh, how amazing snakes hatching out. Okay guys, I'm gonna go ahead and get out of the incubator here and head over to the shop. As much as I love seeing baby snakes hatch, and I absolutely do, I even love the fact that we can pull eggs. And sure enough, I've got a clutch of ball pythons here, and she is definitely really tightly wrapped up around these eggs. Let's take a look. Good girl. Now, this actually is a het russo, and she's bred to a pastel kingspin, which means that there's lesser in there because the pastel kingspin is actually a pastel lesser spider pinstripe. Oh, whoa, this is not a good clutch at all. It looked like it was really good when I saw these pearly whites, but there's definitely some sluggers in here too. So it looks like we actually only have two good eggs right here. And let's take a look. Oh, mama, it's okay. It's the way it goes. Looks like she's got four slugs. So she has four slugs and two good eggs. Again, not exactly a banger of a clutch by any stretch, but these eggs look really good. I'm gonna go ahead and just candle these two eggs just to make sure that the embryos are up on top. And again, because there's a lesser in there, that means that there could be some blue-eyed leucistics, there can be pastels, they can be all kinds of different combinations. So it's still a really cool clutch. Hey, two eggs, hopefully we'll hit some really good odds. We still have a handful of ball python clutches to be laid, and we're hatching clutches like crazy, like I showed you this morning. Lots of baby colubrids hatching. Look at these guys here, some corn snakes. This is a scaleless rat snake right here. Oh my gosh, that thing is absolutely gorgeous. Look at these guys here. What we have here is a couple, whoop, don't get away, buddy, don't get away. It's okay. Oh, Oh my God, I'm so terrible at this. Okay, so what we have here is a little baby snow corn snake. Of course, these are anerythristics and albino, so it's a double recessive mutation. One of the first kind of really designer corn snakes that was produced probably back in the early 90s or so. So it's awesome to hatch one of these guys. And then here's another double recessive animal here. This is actually what they would call a ghost corn snake, and that's an anerythristic hypomelanistic snake. And it's just really, really awesome. It's great to finally be hatching corn snake. Here's some more scaleless Texas rat snakes. Oh my gosh, these look like they're really, really beautiful. You can see one of their heads is sticking out right there. This is actually another corn snake clutch, which is actually a crimson het for scaleless, so hopefully we'll get some scaleless crimsons out of there. Nevertheless, a bunch of really beautiful scaleless rat snakes are already out. Ooh, and then take a look at this. Ooh, doggy, these are beautiful. Of course, these ones here are Arizona mountain king snakes. Oh my gosh, those things are beautiful, but I'm excited about this other clutch right here. These are actually greenish rat snakes. I love greenish rat snakes. I've told you guys every time we hatch these things that I love them, and Lori's not such a big fan. She's like, why are you breeding greenish rat snakes, Brian? I don't know. I just think they're absolutely gorgeous. This one here happens to be an albino greenish rat, and you can see we've got a couple other albino greenish rats in here, and then a bunch of greenish rats as well. I'm always happy when we hatch greenish rat snakes. I think they're absolutely adorable, and anyone that works with them knows that they've got such great personality. They eat really well. They're typically super docile when you handle them, so they're awesome. I'm not sure why Lori doesn't like them, but I'm super excited that we're hatching some. Just really quick, I wanted to show you this. Take a look at some of these rainbow boas. Oh my God, are they loaded up with babies. Almost everyone I looked at this morning is just huge with babies. I mean, take a look at this girl too. Holy cow. These girls are just loaded up. And these, of course, are the Colombian rainbows, but we have a bunch of gravid Brazilians as well. Guys, I am so excited about this. Every day I come down and check this girl. Of course, this is the maternal incubation girl. You can see how loose she is on the eggs right now. Basically, she's at day 64. And typically, ball pythons will hatch at day 58 to 60. But you gotta remember, that's at 88 to 90 degrees. She's been hovering about 85 or 86 degrees. So it makes complete sense that they're taking longer. I'm expecting little heads to be poking out any day now. How freaking exciting is that? Our first maternal incubation clutch ever that we've tried here at BHB, and it looks like at least three of the eggs went full term. Looks like she actually had four eggs, but this egg right back here doesn't look like it's doing very well. It still may hatch because I've seen some kind of gnarly eggs hatch in the past, but I have a feeling that only three are gonna hatch, but this should be any day. I will keep you guys updated. And guess what, guys? Jessica is gonna be jealous. There's a little baby gargoyle gecko that hatched. I mean, that is absolutely amazing. Look at that striped little monkey right there. Oh my gosh, is that absolutely adorable? We are doing so well with gargoyle geckos this year. And I mentioned we're gonna be getting some new ones from Tiki's Geckos this week, so I'm super excited. I can't wait to show Jessica when she comes in tomorrow, this little baby. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, when I opened up Cookies and Cream this morning, this was the first time I had looked at her since I assist fed her a couple days ago because I was traveling yesterday. I looked in there and she was laying kind of weird, and I thought, oh my God, did she die? Literally, my heart sank. I was just like, no, please. But sure enough, they are doing absolutely incredible. You can see still flickering their tongue, moving around completely fine, so they're doing good. Oh my gosh, what a relief. Again, what I'll do is probably every third day I will assist feed them and get them just a little bit of nutrition, and again, continue to teach them how to eat. And it appears that the right head is gonna be the one that eats. I'm gonna go ahead and offer frozen, scented, live, all of those things, but if they don't eat, I'll go ahead and assist feed them at least a couple times a week, and eventually I'm gonna get you little buggers to go. But boy, I tell you what, I am glad that they're okay. Yeah, I've been so busy lately with just everything, the zoo and all the other projects that I have going on, that I haven't really kept you guys up to date on a lot of my ambassador animals. Let me know in the comments if you guys want me to do an entire vlog where we just go around and just kind of check on all the things that you guys know so much, you know, whether it be Bella or Karma or Guac or of course Helen, Rear Day, all that type of stuff. If you guys want to do that, I'll be happy to do that. Kind of a all my pet reptiles again, like I've done in the past. Regardless, a lot of people have asked about Helen lately and just ask, like, how is she doing? Well, I want to let you know she's still doing absolutely great. She will absolutely have a place next door in the reptile zoo. Again, I've talked about the fact that she'll kind of be an ambassador ambassador for how disabilities don't have to hold you back and that she can do great even without eyes. So regardless, I just wanted to give you a quick update. Helen is doing fantastic. And with that said, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here and head out of BHB and head home and see what Noah and Lori are up to. All the tortoises seem to be settling in nicely. So a little family time. I guess we're going to Dave and Buster's. What are we doing there?
We're gonna try to win like the biggest prize they got.
The biggest prize?
Yeah, that's why. Like, I'm hoping just to get lucky.
I hope he's lucky too. Link in the description. You can go check out the whole family fun time over on his channel. Sharing your love with me.
What are we playing?
I'm gonna try to kill the scary clowns.
All right, so we had a good time. And again, if you want to check out Lori's mad skills, Noah's mad skills, link in the description to Noah's channel. Definitely a good time, but we are all hungry, so we are heading out to dinner. And that wraps up another fun-filled day. I hope that you guys enjoyed today's vlog. I cannot thank you enough for watching it. Oh my God. Oh, yeah, I know. And Phoebe wants to say thank you as well. You guys have an absolutely amazing day. I absolutely love you guys to death. Can you do me a couple favors before we get out of here? Can you smash that like button? Turn those post notifications on. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what's going on in your world because I love reading about you guys. Always be kind to someone. And I promise I'll see you guys tomorrow.